Hey, it's Kurt. Welcome to my channel where I review fitness products, do a cost analysis of them, and then give them my own rating to help you decide whether they are worth purchasing or not. At this point, I usually say I buy all my own products and I'm not sponsored by anyone, but in this case, it's a little bit different. I got an email from a company called Power Labs, and they have a chest strap and armband heart rate monitor they wanted me to try out. Now, I do want to be transparent and say, here's the deal. They gave me these items for free. I am not getting paid for this. And also want you to know, I don't have any affiliate links in which to make money from them. So this is a completely unbiased review. I also spoke with Power Labs to tell them, look, I'll review your product, but I can't guarantee it'll be a good review. Well, they happily obliged. I always enjoy reviewing different manufacturers of products that are in the same category so I can compare them. So for instance, if you saw my Wahoo Fitness ticker and ticker fit review, you'll know that Power Labs is a direct competitor to them. So it'll be kind of fun to see how they stack up against one another. I also want to point out, I have only had these products for a few days. So this is more of a first impression video than a long-term review video. Now, before I start comparing the Power Labs heart rate monitors to the Wahoo Fitness heart rate monitors, I thought it would be good to talk about Power Labs as a company. Who are they anyway? I went to their website and there's not much information about the history of their company. There is a brand message that kind of goes like this. We built Power Labs to create training tools for athletes. For us, this isn't just about sales. It's about enabling our customers to do more, go further, and be better. I even wanted more information than that so I can dig it a little deeper. So I emailed my contact there and he wrote something like this. It's kind of like the brand message, but he kind of gave me a little more information about it. He said the products were developed by a guy named Adam Rundquist, who was a competitive cyclist, and he started this online business just to kind of cut costs so they didn't have to have retail sites and actually make it a better value for the customers. They use world-class firmware and parts in their products and figure it's great and good enough for pro athletes. Now, I searched the internet for pictures or more information about its founder, Adam Rundquist. I didn't find much at all. I saw a few articles that kind of reflected his name a few times. And then I saw a picture that claimed to be Adam Rundquist. So I pulled it up and I put it right here. So Adam, if that is you, hit me up on the discussion below and let me know. I hope it's you. If it's not, tell me. Also, we'd love to find out more about you because I'm super interested on how companies get started and their founders and kind of the passion behind what drove them. So if you're not shy about it, do me a favor, hit me up on my email and go ahead and send me some more information about you. Send me some more pictures if you'd like. If you want to be more private about your life, I get that too. So no pressure at all. So let's get to trying this product out and see what it's all about. But before we do that, let's see what's in the box. Let's break down what came with each Power Labs heart rate monitor and compare them to what comes with the Wahoo Fitness heart rate monitors. We'll start with the chest strap first. It came with a strap and then had two snap buttons up front, and you just snap the heart rate sensor onto the front of it. It was a little hard to put on at first, but once you got it snapped in, it felt like it was going to be very secure. The Wahoo ticker also had these button snaps, but they function more to connect the two sides of the elastic strap to secure it on your chest. Power Labs was a little bit different. They actually had a hook that you can see here. It was a little more cumbersome to put on because you had to put it up in front of your chest and then turn it sideways, but it wasn't really that hard. In the first comparison, I have to say the Wahoo ticker was easier to put on because once it connected to your chest, it just snapped in and was ready to go. Although I have to say the Power Labs chest strap was more comfortable than the Wahoo ticker chest strap version. And I think I know the reason why. If you look on the inside of the chest strap, you'll see this thin layer of rubber where your chest goes, and it's a very big piece. And it's also the piece that you use to wet it down so your heart rate sensor can read. On the other hand, the Wahoo Fit version had just two bars that were kind of made of rubber, and the rest was kind of this polyester material. So it wasn't as comfortable. So for comfort, I have to give Power Labs a little edge up. Now, at the end of a run or exercising, when you're all sweating, you just want to get the chest strap monitor off, the Wahoo was much easier because you just unsnap it from the front and you're done. On the other hand, when you come in with Power Labs, you kind of have to turn it around, and sometimes it was hard to get out and took just a second. But like I said, these are all very, very minor things. If you want to talk bling, then I have to go with the Wahoo Ticker because it actually has these blinking lights before you connect it on the chest, and Power Labs is a little more subdued in this black color. But at the same time, it doesn't really matter because how many times are you going to run around with your shirt off wearing a chest strap monitor? Unless that's what you do. But bling factor goes to Wahoo Fitness. In regards to pairing with my Apple Watch, I have to say that the Power Labs chest strap was much easier. Once I put it around my chest, I looked at my watch, I turned my Bluetooth off once, then turned it back on. It immediately recognized the Power Labs chest strap and came right on. Then I pressed a button and it connected and I was ready to go. Now I'm told you can do this same thing with the Wahoo Fitness ticker, but I didn't do it that way when I first connected it. I actually connected to the Wahoo Fitness app, which took a little bit longer. But once you have it connected to the app, you don't have to keep connecting it to the app and it will show up on your Apple Watch as well. So I guess both can kind of pair up pretty easily with your Apple Watch. Now let's talk about the armband heart rate monitors. Both the Power Labs and the Wahoo Ticker Fit come with two different size straps. The Power Labs straps were a little bit narrower and they came with a black one that was a little bit larger and then this kind of yellow greenish one that was smaller. I actually kind of like the yellow greenish one. It was kind of cool looking. And the Wahoo Ticker Fit came with two black straps. They both come with chargers so you can plug in and charge these things up. So both extremely simple to charge. Here's the Power Labs one. It connects very much like the Wahoo Ticker Fit. You just clasp it on, boom, the light turns on and it starts charging. If you look at the face of the two heart rate sensors, the Power Labs one actually looks like it's a little bit smaller than the Wahoo Ticker Fit, but I realized that was just because of the way the faces were shaped. Actually, when you put them side by side, they're pretty much about the same size. Now, the way you connect them to their phone is a little bit different as well. The Power Labs one, you press the button on front, which is super easy, and the Wahoo Ticker Fit, you press the little blue button on the side. So to pair the Power Labs armband heart rate monitor, I just put it on my arm, connected it, then I pressed the front face button, which turned purple, which meant it didn't see any pairing. Then I went to my Apple Watch, I turned my Bluetooth off, then I turned it back on again. It immediately recognized my armband monitor. Then I press, of course, connect, and it connected right away. Super simple, probably connected within 5 minutes. So I love it when it's simple like that. On the other hand, the Wahoo Ticker Fit, just like I did with the Wahoo Ticker, I connected it with the phone app and then connected to my watch. But I was also told you can do the same thing with the Wahoo Ticker Fit as you do with the Power Labs version, but I can't verify that because it's not how I set it up. So in that aspect, I consider it kind of a tie because they're both pretty easy to put on. I think that the green strap on the Power Labs one gives it that little bit of bling factor that I like. So that's the only reason I like the Power Labs version better than the Wahoo Ticker Fit, but both were comfortable on your arm. As you'll see in the ads for these products on Power Labs, you can connect them with multiple devices, GPS, and other fitness apps. And if you go to their website, they'll show you and walk you through how to pair with each different kind of device. Everything's a little bit different, I know, but I've heard it's pretty easy to pair, and they have how-to videos they picked up from YouTube to show you how to do this. So let's get these babies on, go outside, do some workouts, see how comfortable they are, and see how accurate they are. Instead of using just the Power Lab heart rate monitors, I used all of them. I started with the Wahoo Ticker chest strap, then the Power Labs chest strap, then the Wahoo Ticker Fit, then the Power Labs armband monitor. During the test, I put the heart rate monitors through the same exercises to see if they would stay connected. I performed multiple exercises and exchanged the heart rate monitors multiple times during each exercise. So I was really challenging them to see if they would stay connected. They all were working fine and my Apple Watch was having a constant readout until the last exercise, where I noticed the Power Labs armband monitor's indicator was flashing blue, showing it was connected, but my Apple Watch wasn't recognizing it. I turned off the Bluetooth, then turned it back on, and after a minute, it connected. I'm not sure why the Power Labs indicator was flashing blue when my Apple Watch wasn't reading it, so I'll do some more testing in the coming days. I have to say, after working out with the Power Labs products, they were very comfortable. I don't know how accurate they are because you can't really tell how accurate they are unless you brought them to a lab and did a rigorous test of them. But I'm feeling pretty confident in them and they'll work good enough for me. Both products, Power Labs and Wahoo Fitness heart rate monitors, have great reviews on Amazon, so that's a good sign. I don't know the longevity of the Power Labs heart rate monitors, so I'll have to do another review in 6 months and let you know. Here are the differences between the Power Labs and the Wahoo Ticker chest strap version. Both heart rate monitors have Bluetooth 4.0. I know the Power Labs one is dual band. I'm just going to assume dual band is 4.0 and Wahoo Ticker probably has it, but I couldn't find anything about dual band, so I didn't put it down here. They also both have ANT Plus, and you might be asking me, Kurt, what is ANT Plus? Well, I looked it up on the internet, and this is what ANT Plus means. ANT Plus is the wireless technology that allows your monitoring devices to talk to each other. Leading brands design ANT Plus into top products to ensure that you get the data you want when and where you want it. Fundamentally, ANT Plus gives you the simplest, most expandable, and most reliable user experience possible. Does that help? Now you might ask me, okay, what's the difference between Bluetooth and ANT Plus and why do you need both? One fundamental way ANT Plus and Bluetooth differ is that ANT Plus can be used to connect one thing to multiple other things, while Bluetooth is a one-to-one connection for each type of thing. With Bluetooth, you can only pair one heart rate monitor to one computer or one app. So having both is really essential, especially if you have a lot of different devices you want to connect to at the same time. Who knows, maybe you want your heart rate monitor on your wrist and you're riding your bike, so you want to also look on your phone and see your bike route. Most of the time, I'm pretty simple. I just use my Apple Watch and my monitors, and that's all I use. There's other people who get really deep into the data of different computers and apps and that kind of stuff. So ANT Plus is really important for that. On the Power Labs box, it said it had 10 plus months battery life, but on the website, it said it had 6 plus months. So I'm not sure which one to go with. I looked and tried to find battery life on the Wahoo Ticker website. I couldn't find it, but on Amazon, it said up to 500 hours of battery life. They both pair to smartphones and GPS devices and fitness equipment. Now here's another difference. The Power Labs chest strap version has something called IP67. And what does that mean? Well, let me tell you. Water and dust proof connectivity products are defined by their ingress protection IP numbers. The first number after IP is for the part's protection against solid objects like dust and sand. This number can range from 0, meaning no protection against dust and sand, and 6, meaning 100% protection against dust and sand. So the Power Labs version is rated a 6, which is the highest protection against dust and sand. The second number after IP is for the part's protection against liquids. It ranges from 0 to 8. IP67 equipment is the most commonly found in the connectivity market. It is 100% protected against solid objects like dust and sand, and it has been tested to work for at least 30 minutes while under 15 centimeters to 1 meter of water. Now, I don't see anybody jumping in the ocean or a pool with these things around their chest, but in case it rains really hard and you live in Seattle or Vancouver or something like that, you probably don't have to worry about that stuff. If you look at the Wahoo Ticker, you can see it's protected against water because it's rated IPX7, but has no protection against dust and sand. They both have rechargeable batteries. And finally, the Power Labs version does not come with an app, and the Wahoo Ticker does. Now let's look at the differences between the Power Labs armband version and the Wahoo Ticker Fit, which is their armband version. Power Labs has Bluetooth 5.0, which is great because I think the newest Bluetooth out there right now is 5.2, so it's very modern. The Wahoo Ticker Fit only has Bluetooth 4.0 at this point. They both have ANT+. They both have rechargeable batteries. They both pair to smartphones, GPS, and computer or fitness equipment. And very much like the chest straps, Power Labs has IP67, but the Wahoo Ticker Fit only has IPX7. So it only has water protection. And like the chest strap version, the Power Labs does not come with an app, and the Wahoo Fitness version does. Now let's get to the pros and cons of the Power Labs heart rate monitors. First, the pros. Easy to pair with the iPhone. Nicely designed. Comfortable to wear. I really like the blingy yellow strap for the armband monitor. The armband monitor has Bluetooth 5.0. The modern tech beats Wahoo in a couple categories, Bluetooth version and IP67. There's a lot of positive reviews on Amazon. Now the cons. I had a connection hiccup with the armband monitor and Apple Watch. Doesn't come with a fitness app. The chest strap is harder to put on and take off than Wahoo's ticker. Now let's get to the three P's, my own rating system, which is made up of price, performance, and staying power. First, the price. What is the price of this product? Power Labs chest strap heart rate monitor is $42.99. Wahoo ticker is $49.99, both on Amazon. For the chest strap, you save $7 by purchasing the Power Labs version. The Power Labs armband heart rate monitor is $69.99, and the Wahoo Ticker Fit is $73.99 on Amazon. You save $4 by purchasing the Power Labs version. So Power Labs beats Wahoo on price with both heart rate monitors. So for price, I'll give it a 9. Next is performance. How did this product perform? Besides the hiccup I had with the Power Labs monitor, both the Power Labs heart rate monitors performed well. I'm not sure why that hiccup happened, but we'll see if it happens again. Power Labs does have Bluetooth 5.0 and IP67 protection that Wahoo doesn't have. So Power Labs is definitely trying to give you more at a less expensive price. For performance, I'll give them a 7. Finally, there's staying power. Is this a one and done product, never to be used again? Or am I gonna keep using this product? I'm going to continue to go back and forth with the Power Labs and the Wahoo Ticker and Ticker Fit heart rate monitors to test them against each other. Also, it's nice to have two of each as the bands get sweaty and need at least a day and a half to dry before they are comfortable enough to put on again. So for staying power, I'll give them an 8. What's the final tally? Price, 9. Performance, 7. Staying power, 8. That gives them a total average score of 8. Okay, I'm gonna end this video here. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my videos, do me a favor, hit that like button. And of course, subscribe if you want to and hit that notification bell if you wanna be notified of all my new videos when they come out. They come out every Tuesday, by the way. And of course, you can always hit me up at KurtFitFi on Instagram, where I post at least 2 times a week on other things fitness. I'll see you on the next one.